Hello everyone, my name is Mr. Nello King, and welcome to my brand new Let's Play I'm starting here. I know I've actually been promising this for quite some time, but I've wanted to do this for a while too, actually, to be quite honest. I just haven't had the means to, since my last computer wasn't able to handle it. So, yes, that's right, welcome to Let's Play Spyro the Dragon. It's been a long time coming, it truly has. I'm going to start a new game here. As you can see, here's my practice file. 33 dragons. I don't even have all of them. I think there's like 52 or something. 52 or 60, something like that. In the world of dragons. What's it like?
Okay, rolling.
Oh, well, they're just getting started.
It's been peaceful here in the five worlds, or is it six? For a dragon's age. We now have 12,000 treasure, or is it 14,000?
What about this Ganasty Ganork character? Now, I understand he's found a magic spell to turn gems into warriors for his cause.
That doesn't sound good. Question.
Nasty Nork is a simple creature.
Simple.
He has been contained in a remote world and is no threat to the Dragon Kingdom.
No threat!
Besides, he is ugly. That does it!
Looks like I've got some things to do.
Yep, we've got some things to do. Yeah, so, as you can see, How do I explain it the best I possibly can? This game is very simple when it comes to whatever you're doing and why you're doing it. And it works. It really works. There's no reason that you need any more information than you do. So, pretty much in this game, you can run around, you can jump, you can actually glide too for a bit, you can shoot fire. So let's go ahead and free this dude. I rescue Nestor.
Thank you for releasing me, Spyro. Free 10 dragons in the artisan world. Then find the balloonist. He'll transport you to the next world.
What about Nasty Nork? I'm going after him.
Find dragons first. That's all I can tell you.
That's all. Just find dragons. Screw everything else. Just find them dragons. So after you save a dragon, you actually replay a dragon. You can also save your game there now as well. So the game is saved. You do have these gems you can also collect around here. There's like 14,000, I believe you said. I'm not really going to go for 100% completion because that takes a while in this game. So I'm just going to go ahead and... did I get it? There we go. And also, I'm feeling like, holy crap. I'm like super close to the screen. I couldn't see anything. It's like, ugh.
Where's Nasty Nork? I'll torch him.
Yeah.
Keep your horns on, Spyro. You have much to learn first. Do you know what the dragonfly following you is doing? His name is Sparks, and he's helping and protecting you. Keep an eye on him and see what I mean.
Yeah, so as you heard there, pretty much, exactly what he said, that dragonfly is, like, my health meter, actually. So every time you get hit, he's gonna change to a different color. I believe it goes to, like, blue or green next. Here are some enemies I can take out. Ugh, if I actually hit them. Come on, where is he? There he is. This game is not the easiest to control. I'm not saying that it's a bad controlling game or anything, I'm just saying that it's not the easiest. So, every single time you get a gem and you come back to this world, you are going to have, I rolled. Huh, didn't even know I could do that, ow. But every time that you do this, those gems will not respawn. Those gems are a one-time thing, pretty much. It's pretty cool. So, I'll just go ahead and clear out this home world a bit here. This homey world here. I keep on thinking it's like a way to switch the camera. Oh, there, it's the other one. And jump, do that. Like I said, the game controls fairly solid. It's a pretty solid game, honestly, when it comes to controls and stuff. Just, I don't know, I'm trying to get used to it. Ooh, did I get him? Oh, I can, okay, wow. Come on, dude. There's the second hit. Now, where's the third? There's the third. Alright, we're giving them gems. I don't need to save again. I'm not gonna save after every dragon, like I have been. I don't know why I even did that, because it's like, the first two dragons are literally just like, dragons that take like 10 seconds to get. It's like, ridiculous. Let's go and get these gems, bam. So down here is Marco the Balloonist. I can just tell you straight up what he does. Whenever you rescue 10 dragons or fulfill the world's needs, I know that, like, in the second world, you need, like, so many gems. And then in the third world, it's like a combination of like gems and dragons. So after you do get all of his completions, that complete everything he needs you to do, he actually takes you to the other world. So that's the that's a nice little tidbit of information. So there you can see you kill these sheep. Small animals like this usually carry little things like butterflies in them, which apparently dragonflies eat, but I don't think that's real. I don't think it's a real fact. I don't think dragonflies eat butterflies. Just a quick tuition thing. Let's go down here. Let's grab this dragon while we're down here. Rescue Thomas.
Hey, Spyro, press the jump button twice to glide. And don't be afraid.
Afraid? Of what?
Falling from high mountain peaks? Plummeting into prehistoric glaciers?
Oh, that.
So a lot of people say that this one's not as good as the second one, and I'm gonna agree with them. It really isn't. Although I have not played the second one in years. I do remember playing, like, I played this game obviously, you know, before, like, not that long ago, since I just played it like over the spring break here. So I do know this one, but like maybe if I go back and practice the second one, I'll probably go back and let's play that in the future too. So I just haven't gotten around to it, honestly. That's what it is. I just haven't. I've had no time. I'm trying to play a bunch of other games. And funny enough, actually, the game I've been playing a lot recently is a game called Hyperdimension Neptunia. It's a pretty popular game. It's a pretty popular RPG. And like everybody's been telling me to play it for the longest time. I just never. I mean, I have all three games. I just didn't have really the time to play them. So now that I finally can play them, you know, I've actually been enjoying it a lot. It's been a lot of fun game. Yeah, a lot of fun game. Wow. That's good English. But yeah, no, it's been a lot of fun. I'm actually really enjoying it. It's a pretty good RPG, honestly. Oh, come on. I need to get in there. So, little heads up, there is this well here. You do want to go inside of it. Trust me. Wait, how do I get in? There we go. So once you get in here, you're going to find a few more gems. On top of that, you're also going to find a dragon here. Unfortunately, you can't get that yet until you get the get a key, which you get later on in the level here.
Watch the dragonfly, Spyro. His color indicates his power.
Yeah, I already know all that. You don't need to tell me twice. But yeah, what else have I been up to nowadays? It's been a while since I've recorded, unfortunately, but that's just because I've been super busy with work. So, but that's all over. I'm back to, like, my usual, like, 2 days a week. Also, on top of that, was, like, finals week up at school, too, which was no fun whatsoever. Finals and also working so many hours, it's crazy. Bam. Get out of here. And bam. Get out of here. Get you out of here. What's up with the wizard? I don't get it. I honestly, some of the creatures in this game I do not get. Although, a lot of times, like, in giant open fields like this, you can get everyone just by, you know, running into them. It's really not that difficult. It's not as difficult of a game as people, like, ever thought it would be. If you try and 100% it, don't get it wrong, it's a hard game to try and 100%. But if you're just playing it casually, like me, it takes not that much time, honestly. Not as long as future Spyro games. So, there's that. Do I want to go up there yet? Yeah, might as well. I do believe there's a dragon up here. So, let's go on up here. So, the only other PS1 game I've been playing recently is Final Fantasy IX, which hasn't, you know, been incredible, but...
Spyro, my friend, how about a hint on gliding?
No. So, we got that. Where do I want to go next? Let's go up here. Man, wait, maybe I should have taken that hint, because I don't remember how to cancel my flight. I think it's square. No, square or triangle, I think. I don't know. I probably should have listened to the hint now, looking back. But I really like this, because this is an area that, like, most other games would have just said was, like, off-limits for no reason whatsoever. So, come on, get the egg. Give me the egg. I need the egg. Give me the egg. There we go. I also have no idea what these eggs are for, either. I just know that later on you need them, so I'm just gonna grab a few now. So, well, there's actually only one in this entire world. Not even just this level, but the world only has one egg. One egg. One eye. Oh, man. What else have I been up to, man? I was gonna say, I've been so busy recently, I don't know why I'm, like, acting like I haven't done anything. When all I've done is just doing schoolwork and junk like that. Go and get all these, baby, bam. Also, I'll be back to Final Fantasy V probably, like, come tomorrow. But I need to record, like, enough to, like, take care of the rest of this week. Because I won't be home the rest of the week.
When you free a dragon or step on one of their
platforms... Yeah, yeah, I getcha. I hear ya. I hear you. So, what I'm doing the rest of the week. So, Wednesday and Thursday, I'm actually going up to Canada. With Rachel. So, that'll be a lot of fun. I'm pretty excited about that. I haven't been to Canada since, like, fourth grade. So, it's been a while. We're just going up to Niagara Falls, honestly. Well, no, not... Okay. I've actually been to Canada back in high school, I remember. But that was on a cruise, and that was Halifax, which I think... If I were able to choose a place to live outside of the USA, I would live in Halifax. And, like, a lot of people think it to be depressing, but I think it's actually just beautiful, honestly. It has this, like, really nice, like, cool thing about it. It's, like... How do I describe it? First of all, I gotta check inventory. Alright, cool, I got all the dragons here. So, pretty much how Halifax is it's always overcast and always, like, misty and rainy. But I think that's awesome. I love overcast days and days where it's just rainy and stuff like that. I think that's, like, just a peaceful day. And to have, like, that almost every day is absolutely awesome, so. So, as you can see now, I'm getting these little orb things that go around Spyro's head. Now, these things actually are, what they are if anything, like, so if I collect enough of these orbs instead of these gems, since I already killed these enemies and got the rubies, or the gems, they're giving me these instead, just pretty much because they can't give you, like, multiple rubies over and over. So in doing so, these gems, if you collect, I believe, like, 10 of them, something like that, you actually get another life. Which I have 6 lives already, so it's not that big a deal. I'm gonna go and finish up collecting some of these gems and dragons in the overworld here. Also, on top of that, if you didn't tell, that was world 1 right there that I just did. And this is like... Well, that was level 1. This is world 1. So... Alright, so now that we've collected 8 dragons, this will open up. And that's actually the boss fight in this world, which I'm not gonna do quite yet, because I actually still have a few other levels I want to do here. The problem I had with the first game is it's sequenced very poorly. Like, there is no sequencing. Like, I did one level in the world, and now I've, like, apparently unlocked the boss. And, like, so pretty much you only have to do one level to unlock the, like, boss, honestly. And it's just like, I don't know. I think that's poor sequencing, honestly. So, that's just me, though. Yeah, I wish I could aim better. There we go. So with those shields, you actually, like, since they're steel shields, they did their research. And with steel, fire doesn't actually hurt steel. What it actually does is it just makes it really hot. So it's something really cool that only happens in, like, science world. And it doesn't actually happen in the real world. No, I'm just kidding. But, yeah, so pretty much with those steel shields, if you only fire them, you're actually not gonna be able to kill them. You're just gonna make them hot like this. Well, that guy didn't have his off, but there you can see it. Ouch. Let's see if I can run into... Okay, running into that guy does not work. I'm dying really bad. So, just flame him. I need to get a firefly here. So, as you can see there, there's a firefly, and we just ate it. So, now he's blue. So, I'm one away from... Gold is, like, perfect health. So, I'm gonna go ahead and kill another one. And there you see the animation. He eats it. And now he's back up to gold. And I just ran into that light post. So, that's pretty cool. I like the noise. I never realized I made that noise. I was looking online... with this game about, like, little tidbits of info and stuff, but, like, cool thing about this game is there's actually a hidden Crash Bandicoot Warped demo in it. Come on, man. Oh my gosh, I didn't want to fall down here. Well, I got him anyways. I got him. And now give me that jam. No, I mean, unfortunately, unlike Donkey Kong Country, there's not gonna be much failing of me in this game, just because it's kind of a really simplistic and easy game. But who knows, you know, I could still probably end up having troubles. This is the first dragon we got. Rescued Darius.
Big enemies.
Oh, let's see here. Let's see how many dragons I have here. Yeah, that was the first out. Oh, only 3 at least, but... I'm not going home yet. I'm just collecting these gems. Although I could probably just save these when I actually do leave, but... I'm weird like that and I have to get them. So let's go over here and see what's over this way. Ooh, I can't believe I actually made that jump. I didn't think I was going to make that jump, to be 100% honest. And now I know a lot of you may be, like, confused why I'm still collecting the gems, even though I said I'm not getting 100%. And that's just to make up so, like, in the future, when I have to get gems anyways, like, because you do inevitably have to get gems at one point in your life, like, in this game. And I don't know how many you actually need here. Oh, shoot. So, like, what am I supposed to... Oh, you have to hand them back. Duh. Duh. So collecting those gems is kind of mandatory. So I'm just trying to get as many as I can of these easy levels. Because once you start getting the later levels, it gets pretty difficult to find the gems. Yeah, I see you. Now turn around. Turn around. Thank you. Now give me that jam. Give me that jam. Sounds like I'm saying give me that jam. Is it triangle? Yeah, it is triangle. All right. I just want to collect all these gems here, man. This game, if you're like a completionist that needs to collect everything, this game is exactly for you. Because you're going to hate it. Well, not really. 100% isn't like the most crazy thing in the whole world. Don't get it wrong. It's just time consuming. Also, as you can see, I just got a key here. And that's actually useful to open up that box back there earlier at the beginning of the level. So I only have like two more dragons that I need to get here. So here's one of them, and that's Oswin. Oswin the dragon. So now that I've done that, I can actually, if I wanted to, I could actually move on to the second world already. So I'm actually gonna save here real quick, because I haven't done that for a while, and I don't want to die and be like, whoops. So you got that, and now let's go and woo. And also, let's go and get that, that treasure chest with the key. See what's in there. Although I already know, but you guys might not if you never played the game. But I don't know, a lot of you guys seem to have played a lot of like retro games, whether it be like the same ones I'm playing on here or like other ones, but I have like mixed people too. Like I have people that may have like, you know, played Final Fantasy V growing up, but like never played like Spyro or anything like that, which is cool because this is a nice diversity too. So because I want to try and play a lot of games like that. But I mean, one of the games I'm definitely gonna play at some point in my life is Hyperdimension Neptune, just because I've been enjoying that game so much. Like, it's a fun game. It's a really cool game. I don't know. I have, like, all three of them, too. See, the thing with that, though, is, like, whenever you play, like, one game in the series, I almost always like to play chronological, but Final Fantasy V is one, or Final Fantasy is one of those games that you don't need to play chronological at all. And you'll be fine. So that's why I've been doing fun. That's why I did Final Fantasy V first. It was, like, it's not that big a deal. Also, I think I collected it. Whoops. Does that save? Okay, it saves everything. I collected all the dragons. I just didn't go through the exit, which is kind of upsetting. I kind of meant to go through the exit, honestly. Let's see. I almost got all the gems there, but I missed two. But, oh well, I got enough, so I'll be fine. So, that one move on to the next world? I can move and show you where the next world's going to be, at least. I can do that. Bam. I'm trying to think, where do I go? I think I go over here, actually. I'm like lost already, and it's like the first world, man. Let's go, ouch. Alright, so I'm gonna save here. Since I'm up to about 18 minutes, it's saying on my timer. Yeah, save that game. And everyone, I will see you next time in Let's Play Spyro the Dragon. Yeah, oh my gosh, I don't know why I talked like that. But it'll probably be Wednesday, but I'll probably be back to Final Fantasy V on Friday. So, I will see you all then!